Thank you. Those are really interesting questions. What I want to do is throw out six characteristics that, according to, this is not Bible, it's just leadership experts say, your legacy will be built upon these six things. Number one, your character. How you live when no one is looking, that's your character. That's who you really are. While your reputation is merely what others think you are, your character is who you actually are. Number two, your conduct. How you treat other people when other people are actually looking. Number three, your choices. The decisions that prove to be wise based upon how they impact others. After all, leadership is basically making life better for others. Number four, consistency. Being the same person over time across contexts. So when you are at home with your family, when you're out on a golf course, when you're at work, you're the same person. Confidence. When you instill trust and hope in other people, you walk in the room and people go, okay, we can move forward. And finally, compassion. Your ability to empathize and act in beneficial ways to others. Your legacy is going to be built on these six attributes. So, with that in mind, which of these are your two highest attributes and which are your two lowest attributes? Let's talk about that in your group. There is a concept in leadership called the arc of leadership. Now, over your lifetime, your leadership interest will change. Your leadership ability and opportunity will change. For example, when I talk to young people about their jobs, they go, I want a job where I love my job. I want to love my job. You don't have that job in your 20s. Now, the reality is when you're in your 20s, you should love about 60% of your job, but 40% you may not like at all. Now, when you get in your 30s, you should like more of your job, right? You should grow in your ability to get a job that maybe 70% you love and 30% you don't. 40s, 50s, 60s, it should increase the percentage of what you love because you're growing in your leadership. So with that in mind, I want to talk about the leadership arc. And I really want this to be driven by your own group. And so this is really interesting. Let's talk about what leadership legacy should a 20-year-old expect, a 30-year-old, a 40-year-old, 50-year-old, 60s, 70s, you can go beyond if you can. But if you are in your 40s, you have to be silent when they talk about that decade. Let those younger than 40 say, here's what I need out of a leader over me in their 40s. And let those older than their 40s talk about what they learned and experienced in their 40s. Likewise, when we move to 50s, if you're in your 50s, you don't get a talk. People beyond you and people behind you get to tell you their expectations and experiences of what leadership should be like decade by decade. So what if your group is all 20s? Make a phone call. Call a mom, call a dad, and ask them the question, put them on speaker. Or you could have someone in the group who's actually 29, pretend like they're 50. That would work as well. The whole idea is you need to listen, because when you're in the middle of an experience, you may not know what to expect. So listen to those younger, listen to those older about those expectations. And seriously, if you need to make a phone call, do it right now. That could be a great way to bring someone else into the wisdom of your group. And also, if you don't have someone, like if you're all in your 30s, you're all in your 40s, you might want to think about reaching out to others who could provide wisdom for you, even if they're just a guest. Go.
Thank you. Thank you.